Hello YouTube, it is Damien here. Before we get started in today's episode, I do have to put a warning out there for this today's episode. I made a pretty big mistake. Must have played pro clubs and forgot to turn off my PS4 audio, which I do for all these videos. So today's video is going to have all the PS4 audio that you normally hear during FIFA. So you're going to hear the commentators, you're going to hear the fans, you're going to hear all the music. Yeah, it's not ideal. Anyhow, I've listened to the audio. It is makeable. I don't want to really refilm again after playing what was a pretty good game against Watford. You know, I'm not going to spoil the results, but it was a pretty good game for the neutrals, pretty good game in terms of how to start the Premier League. So I'm not going to go and refilm it. If you do not like it that it happened, don't worry. It's not going to happen again. I'm going to make sure of it. But yeah, I just assumed that it was a-okay from when we last recorded, and I just must have pressed the audio on by accident. Anyhow, it happens. Hopefully you can forgive me, and I'll see you guys after this and at the end of the episode, and hopefully it's still okay and you still give us a like and all that sort of stuff. And I'll see you guys next episode as well. Go and enjoy this episode though, because it was a good game and all the business that has occurred so far. Damien, it is the Pompey Fight, and here today in the Pompey Fight, it's season 4, episode 25, and it's the first game in the Premier League. A few things to talk about first though, but we are in the Premier League, and I can't wait to get started against Watford here today. The first thing we need to talk about is the squad. There's a new name in there, so let's get straight over the transfer history and see what's going on here in the club. We've only made one sale, one signing, but that's going to change probably after this episode, and next episode we'll recap it all. Curtis though has gone out for 8 mil, because I don't think we need him at the club anymore, the left winger. He had a year left on his contract and decided to cash in. He's not the first on a few loans, but we did sign in Ijaria from Liverpool. He had 1 year left on his contract. Now, I was going to maybe try and make to get him on a pre-contract, but, unfortunately, we had teams go in and bid around 15 million for him. So I went into, he accepted my contract, and Ijaria is going to be here. We've loaned out a few others, and there's no one else really to talk about, but we've got a couple of lads on the transfer list, and we'll go through why and look at the squad. Ijaria comes in, he's 23, he's meant to grow a little bit more. According to the footwiz, I think he gets up to 82, and I feel like at 23, at 78, you are probably going to get 82. I like his height, and I like a lot about him, but, you know, the player he's replacing, the reason he is Rakeem Harper at 21, has scored a few big goals for the club, don't get me wrong. But at 21, I don't think he's ever going to get to 80+. I feel like he'll stop growing at about 24, 25, which, even if Ijaria stops growing after this first season that we have him here, he's probably going to get to 80, probably go up by 2. So what that means is, for me, Rakeem's not really going to hit that level. He's also, the contract's expiring in 12 months. We can recoup a bit of what we spent there on Ijaria. We are also going to talk about, the rest of the squad as well. And there's a few changes to it. First thing is, Lopez up to 80. You know, a lot of lads have grown. Babadu's up to 76. He's gone up by 2 already, and the season hasn't even begun. Same with Kelly's up to 77. It's quite good to see. But, you know, I think the big one here is Griffiths. The Australian's up to 71 already, because he played in the first team in the preseason cup, which we did win, and we'll go through it in a second. But, you know, he's 1 year younger than Hoover and has 85 to 91 potential, the Australian. And, he should be on paper better than Hoover should be when they both hit their potentials. Now, don't get me wrong, Hoover's going to stick around. Hoover's definitely going to be part of this club, and is going to be a part of the reserves, and a lot of our season is about strengthening the reserve so we can be competitive with both teams in the Prem, and Hoover's definitely a big step towards that. Same with Watmore. Sepp's probably going to outgrow Watmore. Watmore's a very good player to have in our reserves, and there we go as well. The main reason we sell Curtis is these two. Fisher's 17 at 69, and can play cam, and can play right wing, which is a very good backup for Jamal Lowe, and will eventually outgrow Jamal Lowe and probably go into the team, considering he has 85 to 91 potential. It was close enough to that. I know Lopez's potential was 83 to 89, but the kid is still 16 years age, and he's 69 rated, and is only not playing cam because Mascara at 19, he had 75 to 89 potential, and we know the kid plays well. I like that he has 2 feet. Irvine has just taken a wage cut to stay here as well, because he had 12 months left in his contract. We renewed the contract. I think Mascara is going to be better than what Irvine's going to be. Irvine's never going to grow at 72, he's 28. I also think that, Lopez and Fisher both will outgrow them, and they can both play in here, but Mascara is going to be pretty close too. And Enriquez, by the way, has 85 and 91 potential, the Brazilian, and he can play in the hole, he can play up front, he can probably play across the three if we force him to as well. You also got to look at the rest of the squad that we have here. Alvarez is 69 rated already. Harris is 68. Ponce has not even played a game. He just sits on the bench. And he's up to 69 rated and someone we're going to keep around. You know, Cannon's probably in a little bit of danger leaving the club. Kone's a very good backup. Konate's at 67 to 18. You know, there's a lot of lads here that are above 65, close to 70, if not already 70, right? And by the end of the season, they're going to be 70 plus, right? If we play him. Which to me means if we can scrap and we can somehow survive in the Premier League this season, look at that team. You know, Weber's got 85 to 91 potential. Chal Gomez has 83 to 89 potential. You got Fisher and Lopez both playing on either wing, both at 69 rated, both of 80 plus potential. These are kids that if we can give enough game time to, are going to be unreal for us in the future of this club. You know, Kone is going to be a very good backup keeper to Lopez, who we need to keep here because he's going to be unreal and sensational. So those are the reasons why we've got a couple of people like Rakeem Harper. We sold Curtis already, and I'm looking to sell. Second thing is that because our youth objectives haven't updated because we had long-term ones, which need to update before this updates, I'm not going to sign in any youth this year. I'm going to focus on what we got. I'm going to give a real hot crap staying up in the Prem and hopefully really get those youth, you know, the youthful guys in the reserve squad playing a lot of cup games. You know, it would have been a not bad year to be in the Europa League again this year. Last year, probably a little bit too raw. This year, we would give it a really good crack on getting through the group and probably progressing past that first knockout round, depending who we drew, of course, as well. But, you know, with that in mind, I feel like we're in a very good spot with the squad and the club. If you look at the transfer budget, we've still got $70 million to spend. Now, look, there's a couple of ways to think about it. If the right player becomes available, I will probably spend it later in the window. I'm scouting a few lads, and we'll see what we get. You know, maybe we replace Ben Close. Ben Close is also a really good little lad to have around, probably in the reserves. At 25, really isn't probably going to grow any much. He might grow up a couple of overall and then stop growing. About 26 is when he stopped growing on FIFA, usually. So maybe we'll sign another central midfielder. If we don't, maybe we get Close in the reserves. We line out Paul Weber, who's got lots of potential. Go and get him dominating in the championship or something, and then we can maybe go with that. So we are scouting a few lads out as well and seeing what they want to do. And seeing, you know, if they want to come in or not, if they're going to be good enough to be in the first team, etc. If that does not happen big time this year, we're going to go and scout those 23 to 28 year old freezers that are about 80 overall. We can get them on a free, really improve this squad and really give us a good old crack of maybe, you know, this year just surviving, next year really pushing mid table, maybe into a Europa League spot. And it allows the youngsters to sit in and play a lot of reserve games, and it allows the reserve team to get better and will get us to a stage where the reserve team can handle its own in some games in the Premier League. And that's when we're going to really try and push them in the Premier League. Anyhow, with all that being said and done, our first team, though, for this season isn't too bad. It's not too great, but we've got players on the bench that can do a job like Jackson Irvine and Watmore that are a bit more experienced. We've got young lads that we can bring into games that we're winning to get them growing. I really do like how we are setting ourselves up for long-term success here in the Premier League. Do I think we're going to win the Premier League this year? Hell no. Do I feel we're going to win to get into Europe this season? Not unless we win the Cabaret Cup or go on a run in the FA Cup for our first time. If it was to happen this year, it would be an almighty fluke. I must have won every single, you know, live game that we've played here on YouTube, which I highly doubt is going to happen considering the way we lost to Schalke and how FIFA works. It's not going to be always the case. Do I think we're going to win here today against Watford? I feel like we got a decent shot. Now, we are away at Watford at the Sir Elton John, not the Sir Elton John Stadium, but I saw the
welcome
stand,
to you all.
Sir Elton John
Alan Smith
Stadium. I really
me,
do
Martin
love
Tyler,
how the
welcome to you all to Premier League football again.
I really do love the how game coming the right Premier up. League groups here. And the skin
in our game today
I can't wait to get into a few more of the games.
Wonderful
now,
to be
in
back.
Terms of streaming,
first day of the season,
Pompey,
nothing like
we'll
it.
Stream
the
Pompey
home team,
some stage,
don't know what their feelings will be, how confident
today.
They are. For me, I think they're probably heading to a mid-table finish when you look at the talent down there. And they're coming up against a team here, newly promoted, and I'm not sure whether they can make the step up or not. But it's a journey into the unknown for them, and I think we're going to be in for quite an exciting ride with them.
Give me a rough estimate. Is it going to be dead last? Is it going to
here's
be 7,
Watford,
we just
and this
survive?
Is how they're
going to
line up. Nathaniel Chalobah starts alongside Etienne Capoue in the middle of the
we
park.
Are talk about
looking at the front men,
well,
there are two
I really
of them
am
in this
enjoying
lineup.
How much you guys are actually interacting in the comments. You know, got Wayne that interacts a lot. Someone there in the comments yesterday that told me that he is in, you know, he had to be in bed with something like a skin sore. From, it seemed like it was a skin sore. I can't remember what the name is, but he's been watching the series, so those sort of things keep me going. So please let me know where you're watching from as well in the comments. You know, it gives me a rough idea where you're watching from and where this interest is coming from as well. Anyway, let's get into this game. Enough of the pre-game drama. Use guys to keep playing the Premier League and test ourselves.
There's the first whistle, and the game is underway.
And away we go. This may not be the hardest game ever in the Premier League, but Watford at home. probably should be beating, newly promoted Pompey. Anyway, being close, looking for Ajaria, doesn't win out, but he does enough there to force it long. That's going to skid away in this
throw for Portsmouth.
3 minutes in, it is currently 0-0. Anyway, being close on the ball. Ajaria keeps it and goes. And I really do like that he's a bit of a bigger boy compared to Rakeem as well. Anyway, Mascara, first time and our first chance in the Premier League's a goal. And it's one Mascara, the youth prospect, who cost us a game in the Europa League. I'm going to forgive him. I'm going to say now that it wasn't my fault, it wasn't his fault, it was FIFA being FIFA. But in the end, this is why we got him. He's got two good feet. He loves a first time here. He feels very clean. You know, as much as Jackson Irvine was clutch for us, it's not too bad, and hopefully we can continue on and see how we go. Anyway, Michy Batshuayi there, Kapu, and we have taken a 1-0 lead here, and this has been our greatest start we could have hoped for in the Premier League. An early goal to settle the nerves, a warning shot to our competitors. You know, we're not here just to make up numbers. We're here because we're good enough to be here. We're going to punt that one long there to Griffiths, and he can win the header. In the end, it actually fell his foot
first.
One there. Great touch inside. Jamal Lowe now with it. Still with Jamal Lowe. Backstick Babadou. 1v1. Backstick Babadou. It's a great save from Rico. And it hits Babadou on the way through, and it goes out for a goal kick. Rico with a massive save. I thought it was in. Hit his hand, hit his chest, hit Babadou, knew nothing about it. And I thought it was two. And what a start it would have been to the Premier League. Anyway, and Sergio Rico, and I love FIFA need to change how the legendary handles being pressed from goal kicks.
Think any football fan will say, when the rain comes down like it's coming down now, it's going to add to the thrills of a few spills, possibly.
The ball into Ajaria. Ajaria, no one really pressing. I'm going to have a kick here. Ajaria! I thought I just hit top deep. I'm not going to lie. I didn't time it. I usually do. But I haven't been timing them late because I don't feel time finesses as OP as they were. But far out. Maybe I should have gone with the time finesse. I thought he absolutely bent that one in. What a start. Watford can't get out. We've been pressing him. They can't get on the ball. Griffiths has won two from two headers now. And away we go. Anyway, Jamal Lowe looking for one. Finds one. Jamal Lowe's there again. First time. Jamal Lowe. It's a great save from Rico. Babadou is a poor touch. Gets it back on it. Babadou. It's two. And there we go. The pressure tells young Babadou. He's gonna start all year in the first team. And there we go. Jamal Lowe. Juan Mascara is having a worldie, by the way. He's won the ball in two big moments and two key passes. In the end, Jamal Lowe doesn't give him the assist. But, here he goes. Babadou at the back stick. Babadou Coutione. And we
are 2-0.
And away we go. Jesus, now can we press again with Michy Batshuayi inside Pranada, Jason Murillo. And away we go. Hopefully we'll be alright. Kapu's on it as in the middle of the park too. So like they've got quality.
Chalobah.
And this guy on the ball, Nathaniel Chabloa, is usually a very good prospect to pick up on Football Manager. I don't know how good he is on FIFA. But if you play Football Manager, I recommend if you're like a Watford or something, you can pick him up. He does grow if you give him a lot of game time, good English tongue. Anyway, super it's a ball in backstick. Can we win the header? We'll do that. Griffiths again, the Australian. Liking how he
excellent
feels. We scored two goals Chalobah. And Jesus hasn't done a thing yet. I feel worried for what might happen in Watford. In the end, referee plays advantage. I'm actually happy with that. And it's a good effort from distance.
And he's put it away in the top corner.
They've got quality. Holy hell, Michy Batshuayi. Calm down, right? Calm down. What a goal. What an opening 25 minutes for the Premier League.
Oh, absolutely brilliant.
They haven't really done anything with it. One touch. Thanks for coming. Top bins, Damien. You just got licked.
And we restart the game. 2-1.
Now we have to really make sure. I was like, yep, not a problem. 2-0 up. Don't look like breaking us down.
Now
okay. Anyway, one Mascara is a good
pair. That's good support.
And that's in the bend close.
Jaya
wants it. Won't find him. In the end, Clark heads. Mascara again turns his man. Jesus was on. It was meant for Jesus. Doesn't
good
find
way to
him.
Nick the ball back.
Michy Batshuayi now. Kelly, there we are. And away we go. Lopez isn't going to get to that, but Clark has done enough. It's a decent centre kick out.
Good area.
Jamal Lowe. Mascara again. Jamal Lowe.
Opportunity.
Not find anybody. Mascara does well with body. He's buzzing.
Pereira.
He has a point to prove after his mistake. And there he is again, looking for Jesus. He's there. He's got a fake back inside. The ball top of the box. Ajaria is there. Won't hit it. Kelly will force a 50-50. He does. Wasn't a foul on him because I did catch him late. Didn't mean to. And close will find Griffiths and we can recycle now. And there we are.
It's
frantic action. I don't want to even slow this down. Ajaria's goal side of his man here. In the Babadou. Drops the shoulder, does he? Now chips that one for looking for Ferreira. Won't find it. It's headed away. Close can come across and cover here.
Chalobah.
And he does, but her out against ball, decent ball.
And the counter-attack could be there.
I'll tell you what, Lopez saving it, the ball over here.
That's right.
Ooh, Lopez, top of the box, hit, there we are.
Not far away at all.
Well, if they keep creating chances, I'm sure they'll take one. That was a decent effort, you know.
Yeah, it's a good ball out from Lopez, Kelly now. Just make sure the camera switches the jar out.
Now Kelly.
Mascara wants it in that channel.
Good reading of the play by the defender.
Away we go, Kelly there, can chase him and he does. Into Ujaria. Top of them there. It was meant for close. Didn't find him, and now they've got numbers out here. Semmers running alongside Griffiths. Griffiths does well to cover him at least a little bit.
That's an excellent
wider. It's the header. Lopez, though, does well. And doesn't just do well. Bad numbers bombing. And I tell you what, Babadou might get on that. He flicks it, but not into Mascara's feet.
The intentions of the opposition there to.
I haven't seen Babadou do it yet, but I reckon he'll grow into it. And away we go. Prenada now.
Etienne Capoue.
Watford have just. Ever since they scored, it's just been all over us. The ball in the box, that's going to head away from Clark. And I don't mind that, though. It's half time, we're 2-1 up. And away we go. Watford's got to keep coming. And as long as we hold firm, we'll hit them on the break and away we go. In the end, it is 2-1 our way. We had the better of the first period of the first half. And the second half, second period of that first half, Watford came back into it. What a goal. Their goal could be one of the goals of the season happening.
Of course, but they played really well in the first half. Their supporters celebrating that at half time. They know, and the players know. The second half has got to be dealt with just as well.
Kelly was his man backward, but they keep it well. And Kelly's actually been nicked here. It's a good ball inside. Oh no, Frost sticks on. In the end, he went into the
corner.
I'm now worried here from the corner. It's going to be too quick. Kelly standing front still trying to
play it in
the end. Sets got headed away. That's a cool header away. So first on effort, he's straight on the edge of his hand.
The goalkeeper with a textbook save.
We've been on top of this game. It's not going to be all easy here in the Prem. No game's easy. We thought this one was. Been a little bit complacent.
With 45 minutes gone, and on the first 45 minutes for this new club, how do you think he's done?
Ujaria made a good run.
I was expecting better from this player. I mean, he's got the second half to remedy the situation. The good news is his team are winning.
There's a number inside here.
Good vision.
Still there. Set does right. Kelly, get your hand down and sprint with him there.
Looking for teammates in the middle.
Just not any old ball, but
no scraps for the attackers.
Watford really
have
had enough chances now on Legendary to be equal in this game easily. Jamalo, though, gets there first, doesn't, but Ajari is going to win it. It's a good pass inside.
After this,
and now Jamalo wants, and we're good on the break here. Jesus, along the ground, can beat his man. It was in front of him.
For that match.
And in the end, Griffiths is going to win.
Probably the pass getting through with somehow good piece of anticipation.
Straight back to him.
So Real Madrid,
they're working it around the world.
Some money to spend. They have spent it on this fella.
Yeah, you listen to the manager over the last few weeks. He seemed determined,
slipping it through.
Make a change here. Look at his crossing now. Sort of change. Anyway, Kelly there gets the ball, not away. Pass inside.
This could bring them level.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Jesus Ferreira has had a stinker. So we're going to get Enriquez out there. And I have not liked how well Jamal Lowe's gone. So Fisher is going to come on that right wing. And there we go. 2-2, we're 2-0 up.
Well, it is really game on in this match with this equaliser.
And off we go.
The game restarts at 2-2.
Anyway, Ajaria, still with it. Out wide, Fisher. I was going to try and get a bit more control in the middle of the park, but now it's trying to. I need to make a change in the park. Ben closes on the shot. Every time he gets near the ball, turns it over. There's a person.
Clark.
Anyway, not much on here. Set, though, gives an option. Still not much on the end. That ball is not going to work, Damien.
Maybe
just punt it in the air for 1v1, you fucker. Off
you
go. I'm now getting very annoyed. Lopez, that is your ball. Thank
That's
you.
A straightforward piece of work for the goalkeeper.
I'm just going to go long here. I'm just going to send that one and see if we can get someone in behind. In the end, Enriquez doesn't win the header.
Caliber. Etienne
2-2 draw I will take now after what's happened. I think we definitely need to get Ben close on to get the weather. Nathaniel there. Good press from us. It's a ball inside that is sensational though.
Enriquez,
I thought I just pinched it off his toe. Ben close, who we will get off if we win the ball back. Sema, it's a good ball. He's inside. Griffiths, come on, just hold your line. That's it.
That's good movement forward here.
Too, and they just look
like go in from here.
Ben close though, he does well. Maybe we don't get him off. Anyway, Mascara, good touch into space. Babadou wants. Still Mascara running forward. Kelly's there too.
From his teammates.
Backstick ball, looking for Fisher. It's got to be a corner. I'm still going to make that change. I'm still going to get Ben close off. Ben close is off. Weber's in there. We could get Irvine actually in. that makes a bit more sense actually under the circumstances. Maybe a little bit more experience. Jackson Irvine's going to come in there with 12 to go.
We're going to get a corner here. 79 because minutes of that deflection.
Also got a bit of height.
Well, no surprise at this stage in the game that the managers are thinking about making changes. In fact, both managers are here.
Anyway, Babadou's ball will get front stick. He's got inside the header straight at the keeper. Fisher nearly made himself a hero. And there we are.
We've got 10 minutes left on the clock.
Feet. Fisher now again. In there. Good ball towards one.
Trying to thread a pass through, but not successful.
Get a press in there, Babadou.
Well, they came in as favourites, this team, and the supporters expected them to be well ahead at this point.
Now they've got
I don't really can see too many goals. But when I do,
Kelly.
The floodgates open anyway. Kelly, yeah, that's fine.
Deflected out for a throw.
They're pressing really freaking hard. Anyway, Jackson Irvine in the middle of the park. Got to find a pass. Griffiths wants. Griffiths is there. Fisher's not as quick as others, but Fisher, though, is technically gifted and should be able to come inside and find Enriquez. Interesting. Enriquez looking to beat his man. Out there. Babadou. Hit it! A block. That's a great one.
The defenders managed to get in the way there. And it's behind for a Portsmouth corner.
It was a moment.
And a chance late on to turn the draw into victory.
It's actually Babadou.
Put the corner in the middle. That's poor finishing. I think we have to say that. I mean, the goalkeeper wasn't really tested in the end.
It's a bad miss, but it'll be feeling even worse given that he could have been the match winner here.
Can't go forward.
Just 1 minute left on the clock.
Griffiths has done so well. It's probably game over here as we don't throw it in, but I'm going to try and just find a long ball into Babadou. He's going. It might hit him. It has hit him. Get there, son. Chip it. Enriquez.
Well, that's the keeper's ball from the moment the cross
it's
left his
foot.
Got to
be Ushi Roy. On the opening day, we draw 2-2 after leading 2-0
here.
Level
pegging between the
what
two
a start
teams.
It was from these Pompey boys, but a little bit of complacency stuck in, and this game proves, if not any, that in Premier League anything can happen. Watford went bang, bang. In the end, we draw 2-2. It was a very even game. A draw was probably deserved. Watford definitely bested most part of that game, but in the early, you know, opening 15-20 minutes to Watford scored, it was all us. In the end, I think Juan Mascherano probably deserved man of the match. He had an absolute weldie in there, the midfielder. You know, he scored a goal, he didn't get an assist in the end, but he was jolly on the spot. In the end, I was pretty happy how everything went. Apparently, Jamal Lowe and Jesus Ferreira was on an 8.7. How? He got an assist. I didn't even notice Jesus Ferreira had a good game. He didn't feel that great here today. In the end, though, we draw 2-2 here. What a moment. What an achievement to make it to the Premier with Pompey. And maybe the future is going to be quite bright here. In the end, though, links in the description below. Go follow us on Discord, Twitter, Twitch. Keep up to date with everything. And as always, I'll see you next time for more of the Pompey Fire, more of the Premier League. And who knows, maybe we can stay up just this season.